In this video, we're going to take a look at a feature of PowerPoint called Smartart. Actually, this is also available in Word and Excel, although I don't know if you'd use it very often in Excel. I've got a template that I've downloaded from PowerPoint or from Microsoft's website, and it has several slides that have Smartart on them. Slide 4 here has some Smartart. Slide 8 has some Smartart. And let's see if we can duplicate this Smartart right here. So I'm going to go down below slide 8 and I'm going to insert a new title and content slide. And one of the options here is to insert a Smartart graphic. So let's click on that. And by the way, on all of these things here for insert, if you just go up to your insert tab up here, you've got the same choices there on these buttons down here, so it's not really that big of a deal that the buttons are here, but it's kind of convenient. So let's do insert a Smartart graphic, and we get some choices here, and I want something like that, and maybe that is a list. And if I kind of compare what's over here with what I've got over here, maybe it is a grouped list. That's kind of what it's looking like to me. So let's go ahead and pick that one and click on OK. And the nice thing about Smartart is that it's pretty flexible. There's a little button here with an arrow on it, and this is kind of the key to getting a Smartart to work easily. You can put whatever you want to over here. This is basically a bulleted list, and I don't think it really matters which one of the types of Smartart that you choose. You're going to get a bulleted list over here. And the top level bullets are going to be what goes at the top of each one of these boxes. And the lower level bullets are going to be what goes inside. So if I look over here, I see that the first I'm not going to put anything there. I'll just leave it. And the text goes away. But down here, let's say I want another line of text. So now I've got three. And apparently it's not going to put text in there for me. So I just type in whatever I want to. And then I can go to this one here. And this is the top level. And I want three things on this line as well. So if I hit enter here, and then I have to type in a little more junk down at the bottom. And so on. Now, if I go down here and hit enter and then do a shift tab, I just type shift tab, that takes it back out to the previous level, and that means that I want another top level item here. The top level items represent these boxes, so I get another box here that I can type some stuff on. And if I hit enter, because it's still out at the top level, I get a fifth box. But if I want to indent that, I'm just going to hit the tab key right here, and it indents it, and now that makes it a sub-item in box number 4 here. Okay, so it's pretty easy to insert Smartart. When you've got it the way you want it, you can just close this, and you can also type directly on this stuff here and just type in whatever you want. And we're not going to type any more stuff in here. I'm just going to delete this slide here, and we'll go back and look at the previous one. And when I click on that, I get my Smartart tools. And I've got some design tools here, and I've got some format tools over here. And let's take a look at the design tools. You've got some things here, you know, for adding shapes and moving them around. Promote and demote. Let's see if I click on promote here for that. See, then I end up with it moves it up a level, and let's undo that. I actually think it's easier instead of doing this stuff up here, is just to go down here and work with your tabs and your bulleted list, okay? But these are ways that you can change the structure of your Smartart. Up here, you can change, and let's see if it'll do a live preview for us, and it does. And it's going to take the same data, and it's just going to rearrange it in a lot of different ways. But it still keeps that top level for us and makes it look a little different, and then it groups everything else at the lower levels underneath that. And these are just the list options. We've got more options here for, you know, processes and cycles and hierarchies and so on. And I'm not going to take the time to go through all of them. Basically, if you want something, just click on it, select what you want, and insert it, and then start playing with it. And the easy way to play with it, again, is to click on this little arrow here that points to the left and start manipulating the levels of your bullets over here. Okay. We can go up here. We can change the colors if we want. If you want multicolored items here. And actually, I kind of like the first one the best here. It's a little more colorful. And then you've got a bunch of styles here. Each one has a name. Some of them give kind of a 3D effect. Some give kind of a metallic effect here. And so you can just go over here and pick what you like. There's some 3D options here. Some are rotated a little bit. Some are flattened out. And I kind of like that one, so let's go with that one. And then we got a format tab up here, and if I do a live preview, these changes are pretty subtle. I've got this one box selected. Let's see if I can unselect that and select the whole thing here, and then it grays everything out. So I have to select something down here, and if I pause the mouse, these changes are, you know, pretty subtle. I'm just changing a thin line around the outside of this box right here. So I've got a bunch of choices for that. You know, these are much more obvious, but it does do a live preview for us on everything there. And if you want to, you know, get even more control over everything, then just go in with the defaults that you get from PowerPoint. You can go in here and you can specify whatever fill color you want. And we're not going to do that. You can also do some word art here. And these are some options for word art. Let's cancel out of that, and you can, you know, tweak the text a little bit here as well. You've got the usual things for alignment and grouping and rotating, and you can get real precise on the size if you want to. But and those are pretty much self-explanatory. So those are the basics of inserting SmartArt. If you want to try some of the other ones, you know, just go in and play with it, and it's pretty easy to figure out.